Hey guys, hope you are doing good. My name is Aman. Welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, I'm going to share with you some GK portion of Assam history. There are a lot of questions, queries from my viewers. They're asking me to make a video on Assam GK. So here the video is. Okay, and I have told you to buy the book for Assam GK, Assam Your Book 2021. Okay, that book is sufficient when it's come to the Assam history. Okay, but the book is really voluminous, that contains 700 plus pages, so it is really difficult within this short span of time to cover all of the thing. Okay, so that's why I thought of making this video, so that to help you out for the history part of Assam. Okay, so guys, today in this video we gonna cover the history of Assam. Okay, we will cover the kingdoms of Assam. We will also cover the ancient, modern and medieval period of Assam history in this video. Okay, so stick to the video till the end and do not skip. Okay, and do take the screenshot if it is possible for you, or write it down. Okay, so guys, without any further delay, let's start today's video. Guys, we will see first the Ahom rulers of Assam in a chronological order. Okay, the first Ahom ruler was Sukafa. We know it very well, that 1228 to 1268. And there is a question, there is one question that when the Ahom came to Assam. So the answer is 1228. Okay, then second we have Suteufa from 1268 to 1281. I want to tell you one thing here, that in 2020 there was a one question from this topic. There was a question was who was the last Ahom ruler. Okay, the answer is Purandar Singha. Okay, anyway, so let's move ahead. Number three we have Subinfa. He ruled from 1281 to 1293. Then comes number four. So Khangfa is 1293 to 1332. Then comes Sukhrangfa, 1332 to 1364. Then comes Intriganum. Okay, it's not a king name. Intriganum means like at that point of time there was absence of king. Maybe the prince, maybe the king was died and the prince are you know, very young to hold the throne. So maybe at that time the throne was, you know, managed by someone else. Okay, so the interregnum period was 1376 to 1380. Then number 7, Tayo Khamti. Okay, 1380 to 1389, and again there is interregnum period. Okay, 1389 to 1397. Then comes 8 number is Sudangfa, 1397 to 1407. Then comes 9, Sujangfa is 1407 to 1422. Then comes number 10, Supakhfa. I don't know how to pronounce all these names, it's really difficult. Okay, 1422 to 1439. Then 11th is Susenfa, is 1439 to 1488, and number 13, Supimpa is 1493 to 1497. Then number 14 is Suhungmung. He ruled from 1497 to 1539. Then comes 16, Sukhamfa. Sukhamfa, 1552 to 1603. Then number 17, Susengfa, 1603 to 1641. Then number 18, Surampha, 1641 to 1644. Then comes 19, Sutingfa, 1644 to 1648. Then number 20, Sutamla. He came, he hold the throne from 1648 to 1663. Then 22, Supangmung, 1663 to 1670. Then number 22, Sanyatfa, 1670 to 1672. Okay, then number 23, Suklampha, 1672 to 1674. Then number 24, Suhung, 1674 to 1675. Then alright, so number 25 we have Gobar Raja. He hold the throne from 1675 to 1675. Actually, he hold the office for only 3 weeks. Okay, and he's the father of Gadadhar Singha. Okay, then number 26, Sujinfa, 1675 to 1677. Then 27, Sudhoifa, 1677 to 1679. Then 28, Sulikfa, 1679 to 1681. Then 29. Supatfa, 1681 to 1696. Then 30, Sukhrungfa, 1696 to 1714. Then 31, Sutanfa, 1714 to 1744. Then 32, Sunenfa, 1744 to 1751. Then 33, Surempa, 1751 to 1769. Then 34, Sanyufa, 1769 to 1780. Then 35, Suhidpangapha, I don't know where how to pronounce, 1780 to 1795. Then 36, Suklingfa, 1795 to 1811. Then 37, Sudingfa, 1811 to 1818. Then 38, Purandar Singha, 1818 to 1819. Then 39, Sudingfa, 1819 to 1821. Then 40, Jogeshwar Singha, 1821 to 1822. Then 41, Purandar Singha, 1833 to 1838. Okay, so this is the chronology of Ahom kingdom. Okay, so guys, now we will see the Assam history in a chronological manner. Okay, first we will see the ancient history of Assam, then we'll see the medieval history of Assam, then we will see the modern history of Assam. Okay, you know guys, I have told you that you should buy the book Assam Yearbook for Assam GK, but Assam Yearbook is really voluminous, that contains more than 700 plus pages, and which is not possible for you at this point of time to cover. So that's why I thought of making this video, and in this video I have encapsulated all the things in a very summarized manner. Okay, so do watch the video till the end. Okay, do not skip. Okay, so let's see first ancient history of Assam. Okay, so in 350 AD Pushya Varman establishes the Varman dynasty in Kamrupa. Okay, in 594 Kumar Bhaskar Varman becomes the king of Kamrup. Then in 636, Chinese Buddhist or scholar or traveler Xuanzang visits the court of Bhaskar Varman in Kamrup, and in 650 Kumar Bhaskar Varman died, end of the great Varman dynasty. Then in 655 Salasthamba establishes the Malacha dynasty in Kamrup. Okay, then 900 Burma Pala establishes the Pala dynasty in Kamrup, and in 1100 the Pala end of Pala dynasty with the fall of the last king Jaipal. Okay, Jaipala. Now we will see the medieval Assam. Okay, so medieval history of Assam starts from 1185. Okay, so in 1185 Pirsu establishes the Khem dynasty, and there is a spelling mistake, I mean typing mistake, it's not a Khem, okay, it's Khem, K-H-E-M, M for mango. Okay, Khem dynasty and the Kamata kingdom. Then in 1187 Birpal establishes the Shutia kingdom in Sodia, and in 1206 Muslim first attack in Assam. This year is really important, I have highlighted this also. And in 1228 first Ahom king Sukafa enters Assam, and in 1252 Sukafa establishes the first Ahom capital in Saraidev, and in 1449 Srimanta Sankardev born. Okay, then in 1498 Alauddin Hussein Shah of Gaur removes the last Khem ruler of Kamata kingdom. Okay, and in 1515 Biswa Singha establishes the Kush capital, Kush political power and Kush dynasty, and in 1522 Shutia kingdom annexed to Ahom kingdom under Suhungmung, and in 1522 Nusrat Shah's invasion, the first Muslim invasion of Assam, invasion of Ahom kingdom ends in failure. Okay, and in 1532
Turbuk attacks the Ahom kingdom, the first commander to enjoy some success. Okay. Then in 1533, Turbuk defeated and killed. Ahom pursue Gaur army to Kartayar river. Okay. Then in 1536, Ahom destroyed Dimapur, the capital of Kasari kingdom. Then in 1539, Ahom king establishes capital in Gorgaon. And in 1540, Narunarayan succeeds his father to the throne of Kamata kingdom. Okay. Then in 1584, Assam witnesses devastating earthquake. Okay. In 1563, Silarai occupies Ahom capital Gorgaon, ends with Kos Ahom treaty. Then in 1568, Srimanta Sankardev died. Okay. Then in 1581, Narunarayan divides Kamata kingdom into Kos Bihar and Kos Hazo to be governed by Raghudev. Right. Then comes 1587, Narunarayana of Kos dynasty dies. Okay. Then in 1588, Raghudev, son of Silarai and ruler of Kos Hazo, declares independence. Okay. Then in 1609, Mumai Tamuli Borborua restructures pike system in Ahom kingdom. Okay. Then in 1609, Kos Bihar becomes the Mughal vessel. Then in 1613, Kos Hazo is annexed by the Mughal empire. Then in 1615, Ahom Mughal conflicts begin. Then in 1637, Bali Narayan dies of natural causes, and Kos rebellion again Mughals collapse. Okay. Kos rebellion against Mughal collapse. Okay. In 1639, Treaty of Asrar Ali signed between the Ahom kingdom and Mughal empire. And in 1659, Ahom take possession of the Kos Hazo up to the Sankosh river. The Kos Hazo was occupied by rulers of Kos Bihar earlier, who drove out the Mughal Fauzdar from the Guwahati. Okay. Then in 1662, Mir Jumla attacks Ahom kingdom and occupies Gorgaon, the Ahom capital. And 1663, after Treaty of Gilajari Ghat, Mir Jumla returns to Dhaka, dies on the way. In 1667, Ahoms wrest Guwahati and extend control up to Manas River, begins defense preparation. And in 1668, Mughals under Ram Singh I advance up to Guwahati to retake it. In 1671, the Battle of Saraighat between Ahom and Mughals, Ahoms under General Lachit Borphukan wins. Okay. And in 1671, this is important year. Okay. The Battle of Saraighat, I have seen in many questions, I mean all kind of competitive exams, this question is being asked. Okay. Like, when was the Saraighat battle was fought? Okay. So it's 1671. Okay. So in 1679, Laluk Sola Borphukan deserts Guwahati, and in 1681, Godadhar Singha becomes Ahom king, and in 1682, Ahom wins battle at Itakhuli, end of Ahom Mughal conflict with Ahom win. Then in 1714, Rudra Singha dies, and with his death, the Kasari, Jayantia, etc. grand alliance to remove the Mughals from Bengal. Okay. In 1769, the first phase of Mahamurya rebellion took place. Ahom capital falls but recaptured in April 1770. Okay. Then in 1783, Ahom capital Rongpur fell the second time to Mahamurya rebellion. Rebel leaders strikes coin to their names. Okay. Then in 1786, third Mahamurya rebellion took place. Okay. Then in 1794, Captain Thomas Wells restored Rongpur to Ahom king from Mahamurya rebels. The Ahom capital shift to Jorhat. Okay. Then in 1805, Ahom come to terms with Sarbananda, the last Mahamurya rebel leader holding out in Bengmara, Tinsukia. Okay. Ahom declares Sarbananda the Bar Senapati of Matak Rajya. Alright. So there is a word Bengmara and Tinsukia. Okay. The Bengmara is the old name of Tinsukia, and if you have, you know, notice, if you have appeared for the Assam Secretariat exam that held recently, then I think you remember this question was came in that exam. Okay. So there is a possibility this question might came in the AJS exam as well. Okay. The oldest name of Tinsukia is Bengmara. Okay. Then in 1815, first Burmese invasion of Assam. Okay. 1815, remember. Then second, 1819, and third, 1821. Okay. In 1823, tea leaves discovered in Assam, and in 1825, the crude oil discovery in Assam. Then in 1826, Treaty of Yandabo signed between the East India Company and the King of Burma, end of Burmese and beginning of the British occupation of Assam. Okay, so Yandabo Treaty is one of the landmark event in the history of Assam. So do read about it. Okay, it's really important. You should know about it. Okay, I have already read about it, and I will make definitely a video on it in future. Okay. Then comes the modern history of Assam. Okay, and it starts from 1830. The first freedom fighter of Assam was Purely Borphukan is hanged. Okay, then in 1837, Bangla is made official language Assam by British, creating controversy. Then in 1843, Sivasagar sees Fahas High School of Assam. Then in 1846, first Assamese magazine Arunodoy published. Then in 1858, famous freedom fighter Moniram Diwan is hanged. And 1861, Phulaguri Dhawa, the first peasant uprising against British rule, was repressed. Then in 1865, Assam gets telegraph and telephone connection. Then 1873, Assam is become official language again. In 1874, Assam is separated from Bengal and become an independent state. In 1889, first publication of Assamese magazine Jonaki. Then in 1894, Patharu Ghat rice mill fired upon, villagers tortured and property confiscated. In 1897, Assam witnessed a devastating earthquake killing thousands of people. Okay, this is an important year. Okay, 1897. And comes 1900, Tea Research Center is established in Tinsukia, Jorhat. In 1901, Cotton College established in Guwahati, and Asia's first oil refinery established in Digboi. Okay, then in 1917, first meeting of Assam Sahitya Sabha, this is also important. In 1921, Mahatma Gandhi visit Assam, and in 1926, National Congress conference held in Pandu. Okay, then in 1942, Kanaklata and Mukunda Kakoti were hanged, were gunned down by British police. Then in 1947, India gets independence, Assam becomes a state. And in 1947, first medical college is established in Dibrugarh. Then 1961, Assam becomes the state's official language. Then in 1962, China attacks India and Assam becomes the first victim. Then in 1963, Nagaland separates out from Assam, Manipur, Assam. Okay, this year is also important, 1963, separation of Nagaland and Assam. Okay. Then 1972, Manipur, Tripura, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh are separated from Assam. Okay, this year is also important, 1963 Nagaland separation, 72 Manipur, Tripura, Mizoram, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, then 1974, from Shillong, the capital of Assam was shifted to Dishapur. Okay, then In 1979, Assam movement starts on demand of stopping Bangladeshi immigrants' presidential rule in state. Then in 1985, Assam Accord signed, end of Assam agitation. Then 1985, Assam Gana Parishad come to power in the state assembly election 1985. Okay. Then last 1987, the second bridge of Brahmaputra Kolyabhumura was inaugurated. Okay. 1987, second bridge, that is Kolya Bhumura inaugurated 1987. Okay, and in 2011, Dr. Bhupen Hazarika dies. Okay, alright guys, this is the end of this video. I hope you have found this video informative and helpful, and I'm hoping that you have written down everything or you have taken a screenshot. If you did not, please go and take the screenshot, or at least take the screenshot. Okay, because this information are really important. Okay. And thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself. God bless you. Bye bye.